Name's called. Welcome to another video. If you're a sweet tooth person, come on, let's make this northern snack together. Seriously, this one is very addictive. You want to be really careful. Don't make it in large batch, oh, because if you do, you're going to end up eating all of them at a go. So for that reason, make it in little bits so you don't end up consuming too much. So first thing first, you want to pick your tiger nut. Okay, I'm using the dried one, which is the preferred one for this particular snack. You want to use the dried one, and what you want to do next is to make sure you pick it one after the other. There can be lots of stones. See this thing, the stone that come with it, you would think maybe it's the same tiger nut. It's not, it's stone. Some of them, I don't know if maybe they measure like 2 Congo of stone and add to like 10 Congo of tiger nut, I don't know. But the amount of stone you are going to pick out is going to be a lot. So I've done that already, and the next thing I did is to wash this. I actually washed this 3 to 4 times, because you can see the first water, the sand in this water, if you allow it to settle, the sand you are going to pack out of it, so you want to do that. Wash as much as you can, and yeah, just wash and wash and wash, and then you proceed to making your sweet tooth snack. Okay, this is your first time stopping by this channel, please do well to click on the subscribe button. There is a little bell beside it that will notify you whenever we have a new video. Do well to click on it and turn on your notification. Okay, so for those of you that have been here, I mean the T&M squad, thank you so much for always coming back. Thank you for watching my videos continuously. I love you guys so much. So after rinsing, I allowed this to air dry for some minutes, like all of the liquid was out. And the next thing I did is to put this in a dry pan, and you want to toast this for 8 to 10 minutes just to get it toast. Okay, you don't want it roasted, so make sure it's on medium heat. You just want it to toast a bit, and then you do the next process. So when that is well toasted, you want to go on with the next process, and that would mean you add some sugar. I will leave the measurement in the description box so you can go ahead and check it out. You can do more sugar, but in my case, I want to do less sugar, okay? Because if you do more sugar, you will see your tiger nut, once it's dry, it will be whitish in like the skin will be whitish. But because I'm doing more water to sugar, so you see that mine is not like very whitish. That's just me trying to control the sugar in it. Okay, so what you needed was maybe 1/2 cup of sugar and 1 cup of water, but I'm doing less than 1/4 cup of sugar and 1/2 and 1/4 cup of water, so you can understand my own measurement. But yeah, you can do, you if you want it to be very very sugary, you want it to be whitish in color, you can go ahead and add more sugar. But what you want to do next is to allow this to boil, to come to a boil, and yeah, that will make all of the water dry up and you'll be left with your sugar syrup. I added some vanilla flavor just to add some flavor into it. You can omit that, or you can add any other flavor of choice. For example, you can add pineapple flavor, banana flavor, whatever flavor you have at hand. But yeah, I'm adding vanilla. This is just to give it a bit of flavor. Okay, so you want to keep stirring, and once the water is drying, you will see it bubbling like so. Keep stirring, don't leave it because it will burn. Yeah, you want to keep stirring just like that. So So as you can see, the water have dried up, and what we have here is a sugar syrup. And the next thing to do is to add your tiger nut in and stir this, making sure all of the syrup is well coated on your tiger nut. You understand? Just stir it continuously. As you can see, or like I said, I made mine more water and less sugar. So you can do, you if you want more sugar, this can be very sweet and it's additive, so you want to control the sugar at all cost. Okay, so you want to make sure you do it maybe the way I do it, or you want to add more sugar and just the right consistency of sugar and water. So the next thing is to pass onto a parchment paper. You have to use a parchment paper or any paper at all. This is so it comes off easily. If you pass directly to a tray or a plate, it's going to stick and you might not get it to be break easily when you want to separate them. Okay, so the next thing is to quickly spread this. You need to be fast with this because it's sugar syrup and it gets cool easily, and once it gets cold, it stick together. Okay, so you are going to spread this because I want mine to come out single. I don't want it to mold together, so I'm going to spread it as much as I can. And once that is done, you are going to set it aside and allow it to cool completely, and all of this will be very, very crunchy. The sugar will be stick to your tiger nut, and yeah, we'll be back to see what that looks like. So guys, our mayhaya, as the Northerners calls it, is completely cool. And the next thing to do is to bring all of this together. Just try to pieces it, like break it off so you don't get a sticky one. You just break it off. I like it when they comes off single. You can go ahead and do you, but yeah, this is how I likes it. So go ahead and do that. And yeah, it's not looking whitish. Like I said, I do more of water instead of more of sugar. So if you have seen the one that is whitish in color, that means there's a lot and lot of sugar in there. So this is how I like it, and it's mild. The vanilla flavor actually burst up out there, and it was so good. The flavor, everything was so good. See, caution, you have to know this is very additive. Once you take one, you want to take another one, so be very mindful of the quantity you serve at a time so you don't end up consuming too much. Remember, this is a work of sugar. So I'm just going to package this in my mini wraps, just because like I said, you want to portion it in a very mini way so you don't end up eating all of them at a time. So I'm going to portion this, and actually I gave this out because if this is in my house, I'm going to finish it. And this can serve as a good addition to your snack business. You can go ahead and add this to your peanut business, to whatever snack business you are doing. I'm very sure you are going to be sold out because a lot of people are going to love this. So let me know what you think in the comment section. As per always, please give me a like, comment and subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you in my next video. So let me know what you think about this particular video. Let me know if you are going to be trying this. Remember to be very, very conscious about the quantity you are consuming at a time. Okay, have a blessed day, and yeah, see you in my next video. Bye.